Spiderhead just came out on Netflix today. So this Netflix drama stars Chris Hemsworth and Miles Teller. So it's about this research facility called Spiderhead, where they test these untested drugs on humans, on prisoners who sign up willingly. And who could see this coming? Things go wrong. We've never seen that happen in a movie before. So anyway, yeah, this movie is full of quite a lot of cliches, but it still could have been good. I always say there is nothing wrong with a good cliche. I love that movie trope cliche about the scientist who goes too far, if it's done well, but this was not done well. So these prisoners can sign up to volunteer for the Spiderhead Research Facility. So they test these drugs that bring out different emotions in people, like happiness, pain, and basically they're using these drugs to help people. But I feel like this movie really tried hard to make out Chris Hemsworth's character, who was a scientist and this genius guy. And you know he was a genius because he was wearing glasses. And in Hollywood, if you wear glasses, you know that it means that you're smart. I just feel like we haven't really seen Hemsworth in a lot of those more serious roles. And yeah, now they have to put glasses on him to let us know that he's smart in this role. And his character just comes off as this really one-dimensional, almost cartoon-like villain who just has no layers. And like in a lot of villains, you can sort of see where he's coming from, the applications of the drugs, which, as the movie shows later towards the end, spoiler alert, basically they're ultimately trying to develop a drug to control people, to have people being completely obedient. And obviously that has horrific, horrific consequences. You know, put in warlike situations, what they could do with it is scary. But also some of the other drugs, like, yeah, you can see how it could help people to not murder, to be, you know, better behaved citizens of society. You know what I mean? And it's sort of like, do the consequences, the potential consequences, mean that it's not worth it if we could do this amazing thing for society? And that's the basic plot of a lot of these movies about scientists who develop this thing, create this thing, and it's like they do it, but should they do it? Is it going to be worth it in the end to do it? And usually the answer is no, it is not worth it. And that's what I personally think. I think developing a drug that makes people completely obedient is never going to be a good thing. But still, I feel like the movie just tried too hard to make Hemsworth's character, whose name I can't remember and I cannot be bothered to look it up, they tried too hard to make his character into this villain. And then Miles Teller, who I've been a fan of him since Divergent, because yes, I like the Divergent movies, I admit it. And he's also been in a lot of other good movies like War Dogs and the new Top Gun movie, which I hear is amazing. I haven't seen it yet, but anyway, so I just feel like it's just a really, really cliche storyline. And, you know, I can't remember if I've already said this or not, but look, I love cliche. There's nothing wrong with the cliche if it's done correctly. So we have these prisoners on a beautiful tropical island, and it's in this amazing, luxurious research facility where there's like catering and stuff like that. And I mean, sign me up. So basically, there is these weird moments where there's this love drug, and we don't know if when they start sleeping with each other, if they've consented or not. So it's a bit morally grey in that area. The movie never really tells us, do the participants fully know what they're getting into or not? So anyway, I feel like the first act is slow, the second act is slow, And I kept thinking it must be building up to this dramatic, amazing finale, and it never does. It is very anticlimactic. I feel like it just gets really repetitive with the testing scenes, and they're really interesting at first, but they never really go in a new direction. And the dialogue really needs work. At certain points, I'm like, yeah, human beings do not speak that way. I've never heard a human speak that way before. Anyway, so Teller's character, whose name I also can't remember, so he's constantly arguing against the testing process, and there's times where he's very valid to argue, but there's times where it's sort of like, yeah, you knew what you were signing up for. Like, it's a drug test. You can't expect it to be, you know, a really happy, positive experience. Anyway, so we have this girl who dies because one of the drugs makes her really depressed and she commits suicide. So Teller's character gets really upset and wants to shut the whole thing down. So we have, like I said, the cliche evil scientist guy, and then Teller's character and Hemsworth's character, they basically get in this huge fight and he tries to shut it down. And he wins. Hemsworth's character ends up dying in the end. And we find out what he was doing was creating this drug called B6, which is the obedience drug and makes you just completely compliant. So we don't know what he was intending on doing with that drug. But basically, he ends up dying, like I said. And Teller's character and his girlfriend escape into the sunset at the end. So, yeah, happy ending, I guess. But look, this movie even has jokes about poo in it. And I'm like, seriously, is this movie created by 12-year-old boys? Why is there poo jokes in this drama? It sort of felt like they didn't know what movie they were trying to make at times. It was slow, boring. It had good potential. You know, there was amazing actors. The storyline was interesting with the drugs. They could have done so much with that. And yeah, I just feel like it was a real letdown. It could have been so much better. So I would give it a 5 out of 10. So let me know in the comments down below if you've seen Spiderhead and what you thought of it.